طيبا مباركا فيه. الحمد لله الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، والذي أخرج المرعى. الحمد لله الذي أستعينه وأستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في أول كلامنا، اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في أوسط كلامنا، اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في آخر كلامنا. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين، الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس، والله يحب المحسنين. والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم، ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون. أولئك جزاؤهم مغفرة من ربهم وجنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها، ونعم أجر العاملين. صدق الله العظيم. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت، والعاجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام، رواه الترمذي. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. Respected brothers and elders, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this life only one time. The mushrikeen in Makkah, the idolaters of Makkah, used to say, Hayhata hayhata lima tu'adun, in hiya illa hayatuna dunya namutu wa nahya wa ma nahnu bimab'uthin. Used to say, once we die, there is nothing happening after death. You can do whatever you want here, and there's no resurrection. There's no life after death. This is what the mushrikeen in Makkah, the idolaters of Makkah, used to say. And my brothers and elders, today, when we live in this time and era, the majority of the people, they are living their life according to this theology, according to this perception that we're not going to die one day. Death is not going to chase us. When you talk about death, people get scared. They say, brother, what are you talking about death? I don't want to die right now. I'm young right now. I'm in my 20s, in my 30s, in my 40s. And brothers and elders, there is a surah in the Quran. It's called Suratul Jumu'ah. Allah reminds all of us in this surah, قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتِ. Oh, my beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say to the believers, إِنَّ الْمَوْتِ. Indeed, death. تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ. You run away from it. We run away from death. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, no matter how far you go in the West, you come in Hawaii, you go to Japan, you go to England, you go to the East, to the West, to the North, to the South, wherever you go, Allah is saying, فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. Need one day will come and catch you. You are running, and death is chasing you from behind. فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. One day will come and catch you. ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ. Allah will return you back. إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ. Towards the one who has the knowledge of the unseen. My brothers and elders, we do not see things from our eyes. This is why the Quran is hidayah, guidance for the people. أَلَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. The believers who believe on the unseen. Have we seen Allah? Or do we believe on Allah? Have we seen the angels? We believe on the angels. Have we seen the books revealing on the prophets? We believe on all the books. Have we seen the prophets themselves? No, but we believe on them. Have we seen the day of judgment? But we believe on it. Have we seen good and bad destiny from Allah? But we believe. believe on it. Have we seen resurrection after death? But we believe on it. My brothers and elders, this is Iman bil Ghaib. Iman on the unseen. Things we do not see with our eyes. We do not see, but we believe on all these things, my brothers and elders. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in the Quran. Reminds us in the Quran all the time. فَإِذَا نُفِخَ فِي السُّورِ نَفْخَةٌ وَاحِدَةٌ When Israfil alayhi salam will blow the trumpet on the day of judgment, نَفْخَةٌ وَاحِدَةٌ It'll happen one time. فَيَوْمَئِذٍ وَقَعَتِ الْوَاقِعَةِ And then the real reality will occur. The real reality. Ya Allah, what is reality? Ya Allah, what is reality? The life I'm spending here in Hawaii, in Honolulu, is this reality? I came from Atlanta, Georgia. The life we're living in the States, in the mainland area, is this reality? The life we're living in Saudi Arabia, in Pakistan, in India, in Bangladesh, in Jordan, in Palestine, is this reality? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about it, that when the real reality will occur, فَيَوْمَئِذٍ وَقَعَتِ الْوَاقِعَةِ Allah, what is this reality? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers in the Quran, وَانْشَقَّتِ السَّمَاءِ Then you see the sky will be torn into pieces. فَيَوْمَئِذٍ وَاهِيَا وَالْمَلَكُ عَلَىٰ أَرْجَائِهَا And angels will come down from the heavens and the skies. وَيَحْمِلُ عَرْشَ رَبِّكَ فَوْقَهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ ثَمَانِيَا And eight angels will be holding the arsh of Allah. وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا Like we're sitting in rows and saf. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the weighing scale today. وَوَضَعَ الْمَوَاضِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ Allah will weigh my a'mal, weigh my actions. Was I doing this with ikhlas? Or was I showing off? Each and every deed will be weighed on that day. فَيَوْمَئِذٍ وَقَعَتِ الْوَاقِعَةِ وَانْشَقَّتِ السَّمَاءِ فَهِيَ يَوْمَئِذٍ وَاهِيَةِ وَالْمَلَكُ عَلَىٰ أَرْجَائِهَا وَيَحْمِلُ عَرْشَ رَبِّكَ فَوْقَهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ ثَمَانِيَةِ يَوْمَئِذٍ تُعْرَضُونَ Now today Allah will present you in front of the whole humanity, whole human race. لَا تَخْفَى مِنْكُمْ خَافِيَةً You cannot hide today. You cannot run today. Aina al-mafar? Is there a place to escape today? Kalla la wazar ila rabbika yawma idin al-mustaqar yunabba'u al-insan yawma idin bima qaddama wa akhar. Allah will say, Allah will tell this human being, what have you sent forward and what have you left behind? You will know today. La takhfa minkum khafiya فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِ The person who will get the book of deeds in his right hand, he will scream on that day. Ha! Ha! This ha is in the Quran in Surah Haqqa. The person is out of joy, out of happiness. This person is going to scream, Ha-um! Ha-um! People will come to him, brother, what's wrong with you? Why are you screaming? Why are you saying ha? He will say, اِقْرَأُوا كِتَابِيَا Read my book, I passed my exam. He said, brother, what kind of exam is this? Is this the exam of University of Hawaii? University of Honolulu? What kind of exam are you talking about? He will say, إِنِّي ظَنَنْتُ أَنِّي مُلَاقِي حِسَابِيَا Indeed, I was in preparation. I knew I had to leave. I knew I was in transit. I knew I was here for a few hours. I live in Atlanta. My wife, my children, they're in Atlanta. My car, my house, everything is in Atlanta. And if I buy property here in Honolulu, then I want to live here. If I buy this here, that here, people say, brother, you live in Atlanta. Why do you want to buy property here? You're here in transit. You came for khutbah. You're leaving. My flight is at 9 o'clock. I'm leaving this place here for a few hours. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَىٰ We have the same example, my brothers and elders. We are here in transit in this world. We are musafireen. We are travelers. You're not here forever. You're here in transit in this life. When you will be resurrected on the day of judgment, how much will you live? How much did you live on the earth? You will reply, لَمْ يَلْبَثُوا إِلَّا عَشِيَّةً أَوْ ضُحَاهَا And I was there for one morning and one evening, that's it. How much were you there? yawman, one day, aw ba'da yawm, or some part of the day. My brothers and sisters, this is the reality of our life. This person will be screaming and he will reply, اِقْرَأُوا كِتَابِيَا اِقْرَأُوا كِتَابِيَا اِقْرَأُوا كِتَابِيَا. Read my book, read my book, read my book, read my book. Say, brother, how did you pass? What were you doing that you passed the exam? You will say, إِنِّي ظَنَنْتُ أَنِّي مُلَاقٍ حِسَابِيَا. I had complete conviction, complete yaqeen, complete belief on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I will meet with my reckoning. Allah will ask me about my life. Where have you spent your life? Where did you spend your youth, your young age, when you had energy and you were energized and you were youth, when you were young, you had emotions, you had strength to do anything you want. What were you doing? Were you using your organs in the obedience of Allah, or were you disobeying Allah? You were on the phone looking at haram the whole night, talking to people which are haram, looking at haram, listening to haram, eating haram, hanging around with people, you know, which are forbidden. What were you doing? How did you spend your youth? Where did you earn your money? Where did you earn your money? What money did you earn? Was it halal? Was it haram? The money you had, were you spending it in the path of Allah? Or you were spending it in your luxuries? People don't have water, clean water to drink in Africa. And people here in America, they're saying, brother, I want the iPhone 13 Pro Max. Brother, you know, it's $1,500. I don't care. I can buy it, brother. I have a good credit score. Just get it. My brothers and others, we need to see where we are heading. Quran is saying, فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ. Where are you going? مَالَكُمْ كَيْفَ تَحْكُمُونَ. What kind of decisions are you making? أَفَنَجْعَلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ كَالْمُجْرِمِينَ. A person who prays Fajr in the masjid and a person who is sleeping at Fajr time, are they equal? Allah is asking this question. A woman that is covering herself and a woman who is showing off her body, are they equal? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking a question. A person who is fasting on Monday and Thursday and a person does not fast the whole of Ramadan, are they equal? This is the question of the Quran. My brothers and elders, Allah will save you, this individual who will get the book of deeds in his right hand. فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةِ الرَّاضِيَةِ. Oh my slave, I am pleased with you. Enjoy your life. You say, Allah, enjoy where? Here in Honolulu, I have to pay insurance. I have to pay my gas, $4 a gallon. Here, enjoy here. Then no. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, فِي جَنَّةٍ عَالِيَةٍ. فِي جَنَّةٍ عَالِيَةٍ. Fi jannatin aliyah, I have made a huge paradise for you. My brothers and elders, Honolulu is not paradise. Don't get into deception. I came from Atlanta, 12 hours, 13 hours in the plane, to give this message to myself and yourself. This is not Jannah. This is not Jannah. Wallahi al-Azim, it's not Jannah. What is Jannah, Ya Allah? فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنْ. No eyes have seen the ni'mas of Jannah. No ears have heard about the blessings of Jannah. No mouth and tongue can speak about the blessings of Jannah. فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسْ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنْ. Do you even know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for you, for the coolness of your eyes? What is Jannah, Ya Allah? The person will ask, Allah will say the next ayah, قُطُوفُهَا دَانِيَةً. قُطُوفُهَا دَانِيَةً. You don't have to, when you think of an apple, or an orange, or a banana, or a guava, or a kiwi, you have to go to a store, buy it, then cut it into pieces, then eat it. The Jannah, you will think of something, Allah will provide for you in front of your mouth. لَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ. Whatever you desire, my brothers and elders, you will get it there. Whatever you desire, Allah is saying, نُزُولًا. Allah will be the host. مِنْ غَفُورِ الرَّحِيمِ. You will be hosted by the most forgiving and by the most merciful. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and elders, there are three stages in Jannah. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارِ يَشْرَبُونَ مِنْ كَأْسٍ كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا كَافُورًا. You know, when you go on Emirates, there's an airline, you know, they're Emirates, but Emirates airline. They have three classes when you travel. One is economy, one is first class, one is business class. First class is the highest. You have to pay like 6,000, 7,000, 8,000. When you go in business, it's 3,000, 4,000. When you go economy, $800, 1,000. So Allah also talks about these three classes in Surah Insan, in Surah Al-Dahr. The first class, economy class. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارِ يَشْرَبُونَ مِنْ كَأْسٍ كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا كَافُورًا. People of Jannah, they will be drinking sharab. Over here, sharab is haram. You can't drink alcohol. It's haram here. Wine, it's haram in Islam. You can't drink it. But in Jannah, Allah will provide for you. Kaksin, in wine glasses. Kaksin are wine glasses. They will be pouring sharab in their wine glasses and they will be drinking by themselves. Who are they, Allah? Economy class. Economy. Now, second class, my brothers and sisters. وَيُسْقَوْنَ فِيهَا كَأْسًا كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا زَنْجَبِيلًا. They will be resting on sofas. They will be resting on couches. And the hoor will pour sharab for them and will present for them. This is for you. Their wives will pour sharab for them. This is for you. Their ghilman, their slaves, they will pour sharab for him and say, brother, this is for you. This is the second level, which is business class. I'm giving this example. This is not in the Quran. Emirates Airline is on the Quran. I'm just giving an example to make this understand, right? The second class. The third class, my brothers and elders, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, this is first class. First class. You have a personal, you know, just when you go, check personal, you know, first class Emirates. They have a personal suite. You have a personal suite, you lock the door. Right? You have a bedroom. A380, right? My brothers and elders, Allah is saying, وَسَقَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ شَرَابًا طَهُورًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you sharab by himself, and this is sharaban tahura. Allah will be the host, you will be the guest, and Allah will be providing for you sharaban tahura. You will say, Ya Allah, I'm such a sinful person in Hawaii, in Honolulu. How am I getting sharabi tahura from you? Allah will reply, إِنَّ هَذَا كَانَ لَكُمْ جَزَاءً وَكَانَ سَعْيُكُمْ مَشْكُورًا. Indeed, this is your reward. I used to look at you. No one used to come for Asr Salah. You used to call Salah, Adhan, and pray Asr in the Masjid. I used to look at you. No one was reading Quran. You were reading Quran. I used to look at you. Everyone was looking at haram, looking at the haram stuff. You were lowering your gaze. I used to look at your effort. You were fearing from me. You had taqwa. This is why, this is the reward I'm giving you today. Inna hada kana lakum jaza'a wa kana sa'yukum mashkura. My brothers and elders, ayatish have recited. They are from Surah Ali Imran. And Allah talks about, and Allah gives us da'wah to run towards Jannah. All of us. Wasari'u ila maghfiratin min rabbikum. Run towards the forgiveness of your Lord. Run towards the forgiveness of your Lord. وَجَنَّةٍ. Run towards Jannah. Ya Allah, what kind of Jannah are you giving da'wah? Allah is explaining about this. عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضِ. The width of this Jannah is more than the heavens and the earth. Ya Allah, for whom you have made this? أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. I have created this Jannah for the people who fear from me, who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who have taqwa. Ya Allah, who are they? الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. The first quality of the people of Jannah, my brothers and sisters, Allah is mentioning in this ayah. They spend in the path of Allah. فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. When they're happy, when they're sad, when they're rich, when they're poor, when they have money, when they have any condition they spend. يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. The second quality, my brothers and elders, Allah is mentioning. وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ. The people of Jannah are the ones who drink their anger. Who drink their anger. My brothers and elders, a normal person, if he doesn't become angry, then there's something wrong with him. If there's something out of ordinary is going wrong, and he is not angry, is not according to the rule, and he's not angry, then there's something wrong with him. But if a person becomes angry and he drinks his anger, وَالْكَاذِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ, the people of Jannah, my brothers and elders, are the ones who drink their anger, who become angry. They are, you see their face, it's red. They're very angry, but they drink it. They have this ability, they have this capacity, they have this motion that they can drink their anger. And what else, my brothers and elders? وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, they forgive humanity. They have no grudge in their heart for anyone. Today, my brothers and elders, the husband is saying, I will not forgive my wife. Why? Because she said that thing to me. The wife is saying, I'm not going to forgive my husband. Why? Because he said that to me. The father is saying, I'm not going to forgive my son. Why? Because he disrespects me. The mother is saying, I'm not going to forgive my daughter. Why? Because she doesn't know how to talk to me. My brothers and elders, the people of Jannah are the ones who clean their heart every day, like we clean the masjid on Friday, like we clean our house. Clean their heart, no grudge, no animosity, no ill feeling, no stinginess, no bad feeling for anyone. Clean heart. The person who will have a clean heart will go to Jannah. The person who will have garbage and trash in his heart, he can never enter Jannah. Having grudge for people, having animosity. No, I'm not going to leave him alone. See what I'm going to do with him. See, brother. See, you're here, right? In Honolulu. I'll see what I'm going to do with him. He said that to me? Let me see, brother. I'm gonna make sure that something bad happens to you, right? My brothers and elders, who are we the one who are accountable? Allah is the judge. Am I the judge or you are the judge? Allah is the judge. Allah is going to take reckoning. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Ali ibn Abi Talib, Oh Ali, should I tell you the ikhlaq? Should I tell you the good character of the people of Awwaleen and Akhireen? He said, Ajal ya Rasulullah, ma huwa ya Rasulullah. He said four things, my brothers and elders. I'm going to leave to Atlanta in a few hours. If you guys grab these four things, inshallah, I think my coming here, traveling 12 hours, it will be successful to come here. Four things Rasulullah SAW said to Ali ibn Abi Talib. Four things. Oh Ali, should I tell you the ikhlaq of Awwaleen and Akhireen? He said, Ajal ya Rasulullah, ma huwa ya Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first thing he said, Qassil man qata'ak. Oh Ali, the one who breaks with you, you join with him. The one who breaks with you, you join with him. He doesn't want to talk to me. My uncle doesn't want to call me. I'm going to call him. My aunt doesn't want to see my face. I'm going to go see her. My cousin doesn't want to see my face. I'm going to bring him chocolates, gifts, flowers. تَصِّلْ مَنْ قَطَعَكْ, the one who breaks ties with you, you join with him. تُعْطِ عَمَّنْ حَرَمَكْ, the one who deprives you your right, you give him their right. تُعْطِ عَمَّنْ حَرَمَكْ, the one who deprives you, you give him their right. Third thing, وَعْفُ عَمَّنْ ظَلَمَكْ, forgive the people who have done oppression on you, zulm on you. It's very hard, very easy to say on the member here. My brothers and elders, to forgive. You know, one is forgiving and one is forgetting, both things. The Quran says, وَإِن تَعَفُوا وَتَسْفَحُوا وَتَغْفِرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. You don't only forgive, but you forget. It's hard. It's not hard. It's not easy. It's very easy to listen, mashallah, very easy to hear, but to do it practically, to forgive and forget. Forget what you said to me. I forgive you, brother, for the sake of Allah. I have no grudge, nothing in my heart. My brothers and the third thing Rasulullah said to Ali ibn Abi Talib, وَعْفُ عَمَّنْ ظَلَمَكْ, O Ali, the one who does oppression on you, you forgive him for the sake of Allah. Forgive him, forgive her, for the sake of Allah. Fourth thing, my brothers and elders, أَحْسِنْ مَنْ أَسَاءَ إِلَيْكْ, O Ali, the one who does bad with you, you do good with him. The one who does bad with you, you do what? Good with him. My brothers and elders, spread this. Islam is spread in the whole world by the ikhlaq of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by the good character of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Few sahaba came to Indonesia, few of them. What they were doing, giving speeches like me from Atlanta? No. They were tujjar, they were tajir, they were tradesmen, they were businessmen. They started doing business in Indonesia. Few of them came, Sahaba. And today the most populated Muslim state and country in the world is Indonesia. How? What they did? What magic they did? My brothers, nothing. They had the ikhlaq of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They were trading with the usul. They were trading with the principles that our Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam taught us. My brothers and elders, Ma'az ibn Jabal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he is one of the scholars, the scholarly Sahaba, the grand mufti of Sahaba. Rasulullah said, "Oh Ma'az, should I tell you the khulasa of deen, the summary of deen, the conclusion of deen?" He said, "Ajal ya Rasulullah, ajal ya Rasulullah." They said me to wear the mask, but I have to take it off for 1 second to show this action. Rasulullah, he grabbed his tongue on his two fingertips and he said, "Oh Ma'ad, kuffa alayka hada. Safeguard your tongue. Safeguard your tongue. Why? This is the conclusion of deen. This is the khulasa of deen. This is the summary of deen. Ya Rasulullah, you will go in the hellfire because of misusing our lisan, our tongue. Taqilat ke ummika ya ibn Jabal. Oh son of Jabal, the majority of the people will end up in the hellfire. Why? Because of misusing their lisan, their tongue. The majority of the people will end up in the hellfire. Why? Because of misusing their lisan, their tongue." So my brothers and sisters, questioning, they came very far. First thing, we make tawbah. We repent back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Change our lifestyle. Have Allah in our priority list. Have Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our priority list. We should follow them, obey them, love them. And second thing, control our tongue. Don't backbite. Don't swear. Don't say bad words. Don't look at anyone false and discuss it with other people. No, this is not right. Look at your own faults. How many faults do I have? When I point one finger at someone, the forefinger points back at me. What am I doing? Where am I standing? My brothers and elders, may Allah give me all of us tawfiq to implement this in our life, to convey it to the whole of humanity. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Subhan rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al-mursaleen. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.